so many a thorn stood between. But of all of the...
Are you here to get scared? I've got two little scary ones that want to come out and scare all of y'all. Applause for a little scary ghouls here tonight. Don't they look very scary to you? The clergy taught them well. Thank you, little ones. Welcome. Give a round, big round of applause for the new generation of ghouls. Let me lead you into the night.
Demons I've known, none could compare to you.
I had undergone a few, you know, drastic changes in my life. I had two kids.
Oh, wow.
One pregnancy, though, but we ended up having twins.
And I was going to say, that's really impressive. I'm glad you added the twins part in there, because I thought, man, that could have been amazing. Two kids, one pregnancy.
It was fantastic.
Yeah.
But we'd had them in the Christmas Eve 2008, and towards the end of 2009, I just had one of those... I mean this in a very positive way, but I had a sort of an epiphany that, wow, like, I am where I want to be in terms of my family, but
I had to go through the whole because my kids has also sort of picked up on not only me being in a band, but
I wondered,
but
that.
Also this yeah, maybe this is a later question, but just on the note of how you have to explain something, and the a question came my way, and I was like, so my friend is saying, like, Mary on a cross is it's kind of kinky. in what way
you're like, we'll talk about it later.
In what way?
Just
no,
down,
but we have a pretty open conversation about, like, about things, and I try not to divert too much, and you know, try not to have too many taboos. You might say before a subject, like, this is things that you usually don't talk about, but just because we're talking about it, let's plow through it. But it, you know, it came to that point where it's like, because we're obviously in our family, we speak English as well. My son even is almost more fluent in English than he is in Swedish. I mean, he speaks Swedish pretty well. But sometimes, you know, I have to double check, and that's where it really comes to a point where it's like, you do know what go down means, right?
It's hard, you know, to miss that.
Yeah, and then you had to, okay, yeah, okay, you know that, all right, yeah. So in this context, it doesn't mean go down. It means like you're going down in history, or you're going down as in you're falling from grace. But I wrote it in a way that makes it sound like I mean going down on. Oh, okay.
That is a perfect explanation.
And it's like, but you have to, but how are you going to have a conversation like that if you're bound to not talk about sex, or mm-hmm. bound to talk about what people do in real life? That does not work.
No, not at all.
On the other hand, I'm just because we're talking about funny things here. Years ago, when I'm not going to say who asked me, I don't want to throw anyone under the bus here, but it was extremely funny, even though I found it to be cringe at the time.
Oh, no.
We were sitting on the subway in Stockholm, and you know, there were a lot of people sitting, you know, everybody's kind of silent, and then one of my kids asked me, like, Dad, what does vagina taste like?
Just on the silent.
Oh, yeah. And you just see the woman next to my kid who's just like looking at me like, what are you going to answer?
she's like, I'm waiting to see the answer to this.
That's a lot of pressure to answer that question in front of a train full of people.
Oh, yeah. That is.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Mic drop.
Wow. That's like parenthood right there.
That's a win, though.
Yeah. Well, that depends on what I answered.
That's very true.
Go that far.